We are going to integrate L1x over x to the second power. And these questions, we need to use integration by parts. And of course, we'll do it with the DI setup. We are going to pick something to be differentiated and then something to be integrated. And don't forget, we need to have the plus minus on the side. This is the setup. We have two functions, the L1x and also 1 over x squared. Which one should we pick to be integrated? I don't want to integrate L1x because integral of L1x, we have to use integration by parts for that. Let me integrate 1 over x to the second power. And then I will differentiate ln x. Okay? So now let's see, how can we integrate 1 over x to the second power? This right here is doable, but then you have to first write this as x to the negative 2. And then to integrate this, I will have to add 1 to the exponent. Negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. And I will divide it by negative 1, right? So I will get negative, right, because I divide by the negative 1. And then it will be x to the negative 1 power. So we will have 1 over x to the first power, like that. And then what? I will differentiate ln x. That will be 1 over x. Shall we keep going or should we stop? Well, if you want to keep going, as you can see, this is going to be crazier, crazier, and crazier. And likewise, this is not going to get any better neither. Have a sense of danger. This is the first thing. But as you can see, 1 over x times 1 over x is 1 over x to the second power. We can integrate that already. Remember, this is a second stop. Whenever we can integrate the product of a row, we can stop. So let me get rid of this. I don't need that. Now this is the continuation. The answer part-wise, it will be this times that. Positive ln x times negative 1 over x. And let me put it down like this. Negative 1 over x times ln x. This is the first part of the answer. And then the product of a row is still an integral. Be sure you multiply the negative and the negative. That will give you a positive integral. Positive integral 1 over x times 1 over x. And because this is an integral, let's put on a dx. And this is something that we can do. 1 over x times 1 over x is, of course, 1 over x squared. But then we just talk about this. This is the same as x to the negative 2. To integrate that, add 1, and then that will be negative 1, right? Negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. And divided by the power for that, the new power for that. So all together, this is going to be negative. Let me put it down as ln x over x. Well, the function part will be x to the negative 1 power. That will be 1 over x. But then I have to divide by negative 1. So that positive divided by negative, it will be minus 1 over x, like this. This is it. This is the answer. So we put a plus c, like that. And you see, we used this twice, actually. So you can also look at this earlier. Integral 1 over x squared is just negative 1 over x. Well done. That's it.